Greetings, Earthlings! Welcome back to 7th Street.
The whole idea of everything we were doing was never to let yourself get stuck in a niche, never get just bogged down in one thing.
As you can tell by the title of this video, we're gonna do something a little bit different today. For the first time here, I'm not really talking about movies or horror movies. Today, we're gonna talk about music. We're gonna talk about my favorite artist, Billy Idol. Yes, anyone who knows me, especially from high school, would know that Billy Idol is my favorite musical artist of all time. His band Generation X and his solo career. I've seen him multiple times in concert and fell in love with his music when I was like 13. And I still listen to him pretty regularly today. He's one of the reasons that I have a record collection and a turntable. Coming out of the British punk scene in the late 1970s, Billy Idol was really the only artist who crossed over into America and had any real continuous success on the pop charts. With his bleach blonde hair and leather pants, he was pretty much made for the MTV era. He had a string of hits all throughout the 80s, even into the 90s, winning a Grammy. So I thought that it would be fun to take a look at this diehard Billy Idol fan's top 5 favorite Billy Idol songs. And I just want to let you guys know ahead of time right now, just so that nobody freaks out and leaves me any comments down below. No, White Wedding is not going to be on my top 5 list. Number 5, Catch My Fall. Catch my Just one of the many hit singles off of Billy Idol's Rebel Yell album, Catch My Fall is the one that feels quite a bit different from the others, and this is no doubt one of the reasons that it immediately jumped out at me when I first started listening to Billy Idol. Of course, like most people who came after an artist was popular, my first CD that I bought of Billy Idol's was his Greatest Hits album. Now, of course, I was already familiar with White Wedding and Rebel Yell, but Catch My Fall was the first one that really, really jumped out at me and I really fell in love with. It's kind of got a little bit of everything to it, and at the same time being just different. I mean, you have like the really heavy guitar and kind of this catchy little bass riff, but you also have things like a saxophone in there and kind of like a weird drum machine that's in there. If I should stumble, catch my fall. If I should stumble. Kind of crosses between being this sort of pop glam punk song and kind of like a dance song, and it's just, it's so bizarre and so different. It's also a really interesting song because it's clearly like a self-reflection of his own heroin addiction at the time and kind of falling deeper and deeper into drug addiction, which is sort of a ongoing theme with Billy Idol, but it's interesting to see it so early in his career. You know, in the first two albums that he put out, they're very, very 80s, very early 80s, trying to be kind of like these radio, kind of poppy albums, which was really different from what he was doing with Generation X. And you can tell that he was trying to do something different. And, you know, Catch My Fall is just like the weird one on that album that really stands out and is kind of like this really kind of depressing subject matter disguised as sort of this like faux glam punk dance song. And it's just an interesting song, man. I think that it really holds up well. It's not one that you ever hear about. It kind of seems to be like the runt of the singles that came off of the Rebel Yell album, but I think arguably it's one of the best, maybe on certain days, maybe the best. It, you know, I think you could certainly make the argument for why that song, you know, should be, just should be more popular than some of the other ones, especially something like Flesh for Fantasy or maybe even Eyes Without a Face. I think that it's a really interesting like self-reflection of an artist who clearly at this point was starting to go a little, like live a little too fast and loose at the time. And I mean, it's like, it's right there in the title, Catch My Fall. That's the whole song is about, it's about, you know, hopefully someone can like pull me back once I've gone too far. Just a really, really interesting, really fun song. Number four, Rebel Yell. Yes, I know Rebel Yell is number four on my top five favorite Billy Idol songs list. And I know that this will probably be met with some criticism from some of his other diehard fans. And it truly is a fantastic song. It's clearly Billy Idol's favorite. It's the best one to see live, at least nowadays. It's the one that Billy Idol gets into the most. The crowd gets into it the most. It's sort of his landmark song. Rebel Yell is really interesting in that it's another one that's very dark and very sinister, but it's not really disguising that so much. I think that it's just sometimes misunderstood when people just kind of like gloss over it, especially a lot of times with those kind of hard rock, kind of anthem, glam punk artists from the 80s. Most people take a lot of their songs at face value because there's not really anything to look into, and people just kind of say, oh, it's about having sex with women, which is sort of true, but I would argue that there's quite a bit more going on with Rebel Yell than just that. Like I said, it's very dark, very sinister. It seems to be pretty clearly him bragging about his drug-fueled sex life with his longtime girlfriend, Perry Lester, who is also a dancer, stripper. I know she worked with like a burlesque show in the UK in like the early to mid 70s. And it's just kind of like, it's like the most, it's not just a song about sex. It seems to more be like this very like, sinister, cynical, dark love song, kind of like this love story, kind of almost feels like it should be like a song that was in the movie Sid and Nancy. It kind of almost like perfectly describes that life, you know, because there are multiple points in the song where he's like talking about getting drugs too, so it's not just clear, it's not just about sex. It's kind of like the, you know, their whole relationship, like the characters within the song, their whole relationship is just built off of this kind of like drug-fueled sex that they have, and him feeling like his soul is being stolen through like her having sex with him, which is just kind of it's just very like devilish kind of song. And man, I mean, it, especially if you like listen to the newer Billy Idol like dance album, the revitalized album that was just released, they like slow down the tempo, like the drums, it's like slowed down like to a fourth of its original speed, and I swear to God, it sounds like the perfect song that should be playing in a strip club. It's just got this sort of seedy, kind of sweaty, sexy, kind of grungy feel to it. It's just such a fun song. It's so high octane, and yeah, I mean, what else am I going to say about Rebel Yell? I mean, most people would put this as their number one. Number three, To Be a Lover. Whiplash Smile is the best Billy Idol album. And I don't even know how people debate this. And this is coming from someone who's a diehard fan, who's looking at all of these albums, most of his albums in totality, in retrospect, and being able to listen to them front to back, one after another, and judge it that way, and not being like biased on, well, you know, this one came out when I was in middle school, so this is why I like this one. So I feel like, I don't know, maybe I have just like a different point of view on it, but I'm telling you, man, Whiplash Smile is clearly his best album. It came out in 1987. It's like the entire album is like kind of depressing and dark, and you can almost feel the frustrations from his worsening heroin addiction just like bleeding through the speakers when you listen to that album. Everything is so dark and downbeat, except for To Be a Lover. Didn't I say all those loving special things? Which is like this kind of crazy, frenetic, ragtime kind of song. I know that it was, I think it was like originally a Perry Como piano ballad. And this is like, Billy Idol makes it like it's on crack or something. It's very fast paced with like crazy, like the piano's going so fast and you've got Steve Stevens shredding on his guitar and it's so bluesy. And it's no wonder that Billy Idol was nominated for Best Male Vocals in 1987 for that album. I think that To Be a Lover is like one of the best examples of that, of why he was nominated. He's really wailing and kind of gives you a little bit of everything that he has in his repertoire. And I always tell people when they're like, oh, you like Billy Idol, and they don't know anything about him, I'm always like, or they don't listen to his music very much, I'm like, man, he's kind of like this like cross between a punk rocker and Jim Morrison. He's just got this like Jim Morrison way about his singing, and it really shines through on that album, and I think it really shines through on To Be a Lover. I think it's just a fantastic song, and I mean, I know that it's not written by Billy Idol, but it's so perfect for him. Like, the lyrics and everything are just fantastic. When I realize that you need love too, I'm gonna spend my life making love for you. It's kind of got like this Elvis-y vibe to it. It's really kind of like the first time since the Generation X song King Rocker that he really seems to be in like his like full-blown mock Elvis, mock Jim Morrison. Fantastic. It's just like this great, like, everything. It's like a dance song. It's just, it's got a little bit of something for everybody. It's really just a terrific, terrific song on a terrific album. Number two, Man for All Seasons. I'm a man for the seasons. Yes, I'm Once again, like I said, I love the album Whiplash Smile. I don't understand how people don't think that this is his greatest album. To me, it's far and away. I mean, the only way to listen to this album is front to back. Every single song on this album is fantastic. I mean, it's just like, you can wail to it. It feels, like I said, just so like depressing and dark and like, you know, you can like almost feel kind of like the angst that he was feeling at the time. And his debut album and Rebel Yell came out within like less than 2 years of each other. And then he took more than three years to release Whiplash Smile, and you can tell he like really took his time with this album and really kind of felt out what he wanted to do with his like persona and with his musical style. And I think no better song showcases this than Man for All Seasons. I'm on my side, now you understand. Oh baby, my time is at hand. It amazes me that this song was not a single off of the album when something like Sweet 16 was a single, and a single that was marketed really heavily and charted pretty well. And in my opinion, I think that Sweet 16 is the most out of place and probably the worst song on the album. Man for All Seasons just goes heavy. It's got a really heavy bluesy guitar, and Billy Idol is just wailing in this song. It's absolutely fantastic. I know that this is the only deep cut that I have on this list, and I'm totally willing to do my top five favorite Billy Idol deep cuts, because his deep cuts are probably the songs that I listen to most nowadays. So I'd be interested in doing that video for you guys if anybody wants me to. But yeah, Man for All Seasons is not only the best Billy Idol deep cut, but in my opinion, it's like his second best song. Number one, Hot in the City. You know, I would have been lying to myself if I put anything other than Hot in the City as my number one favorite Billy Idol song. I know that I kind of just got done saying that, you know, what most people think about when they think about Billy Idol is kind of like this, like, kind of, they think of his first two albums, they think of kind of like this, like, kind of trying to be poppy, trying to get on the radio, kind of cartoon punk rock. And, you know, it kind of always pains me because I want to point someone towards something like Whiplash Smile or maybe even like Devil's Playground or something to kind of like, because that's what I think of a little bit more when I think of Billy Idol, kind of more of a bluesy, like this punk rock mixed with this kind of Jim Morrison feel to it. But Hot in the City is probably my favorite song. It's one that I really, really liked when I was young, and it still has carried over to this day, especially when the weather starts getting nice. It's a song that I listen to regularly. I also really, really like the dance remixes on Vital Idol and on the new Billy Idol Revitalized. I think it's the best dance remix that's on there. It's kind of got like this Florida, kind of Caribbean feel to it. It's just one of those songs that can be played in like a multitude of different ways, and it still really works and really holds up. It's really fun. It's like a summer sweaty sex anthem. I mean, what else do you want from Billy Idol? It's hot in the night, lonely black and white on a hot summer night. Don't be afraid of the world we made on a hot summer night. Cause when a lonely, lovely walks by, you can see a look in her eye, and you know that it's hot in the city, hot in the city tonight. I don't know how else to defend it at this point. So anyways, guys, that's it, I guess. This was a pretty easy video to make. Wasn't really much to it. If you guys want to see me do, like, some other, like, music-related videos, I'd be totally interested in doing those. If you want to see me do some more Billy Idol stuff, I can do that as well. I can go in a little bit more in-depth into some of the songs, I guess. I just thought that I would like rattle off my top five here and kind of do something a little bit different. So yeah, guys, make sure that you follow us on Facebook and on Instagram. Find me on Patreon as well. You know, I know that times are tough right now, so I shouldn't be asking for a handout. But anyways, guys, until next time.